Hey guys, what's going on? It's Jay from Sony Alpha Lab, and what I got here is the Sony A7 III. But what I'm going to go over in this video is touch focus. So this will apply to pretty much all the cameras that have a touch screen that are Sony made, you know what I'm saying? So first thing you got to do is you're going to have to enable the touch operation. So that's in here on the A7 III, it's in setup 2, and you just got to go to touch operation, and you got to turn that on, okay? I have it on. And then if you go to the next page, you have a bunch of other features. I just want to go over those really quick. It's not going to take long. So what you have is touch panel and touch pad. All right. So the panel, what they're calling the panel is the LCD screen. Okay. What they're calling the pad is when you're using the EVF. So when you're using the electronic viewfinder, the LCD screen then becomes effectively a pad. And you could, while looking through the EVF, you could still have your thumb on the screen and change the focus point using the touch pad. Sony's considering the LCD screen a panel. So these are the options there. If you don't want to use the touch screen while you're using the EVF, just do panel only. And if you don't want to use the touch screen when using the panel, just do pad only. I like it with both on there. So that's what that means. Now, touch pad settings. When you're in the vertical orientation, like if you have the camera like tilted, you know, the other way, so you're shooting vertical as opposed to landscape style like it is right now, you can turn that off. And the reason why you might want to is it's possible that your nose or something might be rubbing the screen if you're using the EVF in a vertical position, and it might be changing your focus point on you. So you can turn that off if you want. That's actually a really nice feature. I have it on for now. I haven't ran into any problems yet. Touch position mode. This, I highly recommend you select relative, because when you're using the electronic viewfinder, you basically have your thumb on the screen. And when you move your thumb around, it's nice to have it just relative. So for example, if the focus point is up high and you put your thumb down low, if you go lower, the focus point will go lower. If you have that setting set to absolute, if you have your thumb down here, you know, the focus point will just move right to where your thumb is. Now you might want that, but when you're using the electronic viewfinder, it's kind of hard to see where your thumb is on the screen because you're looking through here. So you're kind of going by feel. So I particularly like the relative position. I played with both extensively, and the relative position is definitely better from every aspect I could think of, at least for my purposes. Now, operation area, this you can change. I particularly, again, I played with a bunch of these settings, and the right side of the screen seemed to work out best when I had my eye on the EVF, okay? So the right one half is how I have that set. You can play around with that depending if you're a lefty or something and you're using your left eye in here. You might want the left side of the screen, for example. So that's what that means, all right? Now, the only other setting we have to check before we do this, so the last thing we need to check, if I go to menu, and let me just scroll to the right because it's faster that way, we need to go to center lock AF, okay? See that set center lock on AF? You need to have that off, okay? Make sure that's off. All right, and now that we're set there, now we have touch focus enabled. Let me just go to the function menu, and you can see here I have my focus area. It's set to wide mode, and I'm in single shot AF, and I also have the self timer set, not that that really matters, but the wide focus area is key. The two focus modes you don't want to use while using touch focus, pretty much, is the flexible spot and expandable flexible spot. Now you can use these features, but they stay. Like, you know, so if you touch the screen with that mode, it's gonna stay where you touch it. The other modes override the given mode. So in wide area mode, right now it's in wide area, so it's gonna focus on whatever's closest to the camera. So it's picking this quarter right here to focus on. But I can simply override it by hitting the touch. Now, because I touched the screen, notice how this little finger with the X came up there. See that? That's letting me know that the focus is now set via touch, and I could cancel that at any time and go back to wide mode. Okay, so I just canceled it. Now it's back in wide mode, you see? How cool is that? And this also works for video. So if I'm recording video, I can just touch over here on the quarter, for example, and it should focus on that, and then if I click over on the dollar bill, it'll switch to that. And then notice the little hand with the cancel is still there, so I can cancel that. And now it's gonna go, once I cancel it, it's gonna go back to the default focus area mode that I had selected, which is wide. So that's how that works. So that is pretty much it for touch focus, guys. So like I said, you can have, if I go back to the function menu, you can change your focus mode to like center, let's say. And then now it's stuck on the center. So let me change my touch focus to like somewhere over here on the background. So now it's focusing on that, right? But I want it to be back on the center. Well, another way you can cancel that is by hitting this center button here. All right, so if you hit the center button, that'll also cancel the touch focus and it'll go back to center focus mode. You see that? So you can do it by either pressing the little X with the finger, or you can just hit this center button, and that works for both video and photography mode. So again, I told you this video was gonna be quick. That's really all there is to it. Now, the reason why I wanted to show you this in particular is because the touch focus is turned off by default. It's not on by default. So it's important that you know how to turn it on and use this feature, because this right here is set to off when you get the camera out of the box. So you might be touching the screen and being like, how does this work? And then you might turn it on and not understand how it works. So, but there's really not much to it. It's pretty fairly straightforward. So hopefully this video helped you out with that. And you know, if you guys have any questions, absolutely ask below the video. Be sure to hit that thumbs up and the notification icon and subscribe. And I'd really appreciate that. All the relative links will be below the video in that show more area. The description area below the video will be links. If you guys are doing some shopping and things like that, that'll all be below the video. Also, other tutorial guides will be linked below the video as well. Have a great day. Take care.